Listen, you cannot glow if your skin is ashy. And just because you're on a budget doesn't mean you have to stay with your dry, ashy skin all season long. I'm going to be showing you some tips on how to get glowing skin with products that are under $20, mostly under $10, but it was just that one product that I really wanted you to know about that was a little bit more than $10, so keep watching. Now, I have done enough videos for you to know by now that the hot waters in the showers ain't gonna cut it for your skin. But in case you missed the memo, skin of color already suffers from transepidermal water loss. This basically means that our skin has a hard time holding on to the hydration that it desperately needs. As soon as it gets the hydration in, it loses it. Hot water makes that worse. So turn down the bomba clot water temperature in your shower and your bath. And no, you cannot just double up on the body butters and the oils. As a matter of fact, Dr. Alexis and I have a video coming up where she kind of tells y'all about yourselves on that, so make sure you stay tuned. Now, exfoliation is key to shedding some of the accumulation of dead skin cells laying on your skin that are literally stealing your shine. However, darling, with our skin, you need to be gentle and have a good balance of exfoliation. You don't want to over exfoliate and irritate the skin, because that irritation can lead to inflammation that's gonna lead to hyperpigmentation. And you don't want to under exfoliate, because then, yeah. So I'd say that 2 times a week is probably a good sweet spot. And remember that a lot of things count as exfoliation. Simply rubbing your hands on your skin is a form of exfoliation. Scrubs are a form of exfoliation. Using a loofah, a net, or a body brush, depending on the towel that you're using to dry off your skin, that can count as exfoliation. And of course, we have the chemical exfoliants that are found in a lot of body washes and body products. So currently in my body skincare routine, I like to use this $8 Mario Badescu AHA body wash. It utilizes alpha hydroxy acids to chemically exfoliate the skin. So you get a gentle exfoliation without using scrub. However, if you prefer a scrub, be mindful of the size and the texture of the scrub, because something that's a little too big and maybe a little too uneven is gonna scratch up your skin. And that roughing up of the skin can lead to irritation, that can lead to inflammation, that can lead to hyperpigmentation. You know what I'm saying? But if you want to try a scrub, Shea Moisture has these really amazing scrubs, the $8.99 coconut hibiscus scrub, which I have used before in the past. I like it because it has like these oils in it that feels really moisturizing, and the granules are even and fine, and it doesn't like rough up the skin. Now, it does have fragrance in it, and while everyone's skin is different, if you are dealing with really dry, sensitive skin, especially in the colder months, you might want to look at things that are fragrance-free. And I looked and I searched and I tried to find you a fragrance-free scrub that was in the price point for this video. And you know, because we are a community here, if you use a fragrance-free scrub in your routine, leave a comment below and let your fellow woman and man know about it. Now, for my brothers and sisters with psoriasis and eczema, you want to be particularly careful because this time of year can really trigger flare-ups. So definitely check in with your dermatologist before you try any of this stuff, because what you're not going to do is be like, well, Danielle said. Now, in my shower routine video, which if you haven't checked out, make sure you check it out, I mentioned that I am currently using and loving this Ceramedics Ultra Moisturizing Cream. It has vitamin F, it has ceramides. Make sure you check out that video for more tea. But if you were looking for another cream that is under $20, check out Vanicream. I was trying to get a tub of it to show you in this video and to, you know, like show you what the texture and whatnot looks like, but my Target was sold out. Now, if you've tried Vanicream before, you know you're gonna do your community duties and leave your experience, good or bad, in the comments so that we can all know about it. But Vanicream is a brand that a lot of the dermatologists that we know and love like to recommend. Now, in the wintertime, when you're moisturizing your body, you're probably gonna want a thick cream or even a balm, depending on what the temperature's doing where you live. But you're probably gonna need something a little bit more than what you use in the summertime. Now, if you fall into that category or you just prefer a lotion, I recently tried this Vaseline Extremely Dry Skin Rescue. Sometimes you gotta get to the point on the packaging of your product, right? But this is fragrance-free. It has glycerin, which is a humectant that draws the moisture into the skin, but it also contains ingredients that help to seal in that moisturization. I found it to be lightweight and very nice on the skin. I'd probably wear something like this when it's not as cold, but when it gets really, really cold, I'll probably switch to the thick creams and the balms. Now, sometimes it gets really cold and dry and you need a lot, or if your skin is just really dry and sensitive and just doing the most, you probably gonna want a thick balm. So let's talk about some balms. Now, this gets fear-mongered a lot. No, it is not quite the same as putting gasoline on your face. Vaseline petroleum jelly is probably one of the best things you can do for your severely dry skin. It is a very occlusive moisturizer that is just going to keep that moisture in. Remember I told you about the transepidermal water loss? Our hydration gets in the body and it's like, right? The Vaseline and other types of occlusive moisturizers like this help to keep that in. So what you can do with this, as soon as you get out the shower while your skin is still wet, you can slather yourself up with some Vaseline, or you can kind of dry off while your skin is still a little bit damp. You can put your moisturizer on and then put this on top. You might have to try a couple of different options out depending on how cold it gets and what your skin is doing. This is also extremely multitasking because you can use it on your hands and your feet to kind of soften them up. You can use this on your lips. You can also use this on areas where you get maskne, because what's happening is your mask is rubbing up against your skin and this can kind of help to stop that friction, thereby decreasing the amount of maskne that you get. And no, it will not clog your skin. So there's a video on maskne that we did with some tips from acne expert Marie Claire Cates. I will link to that, as well as a video from Dr. Dre where she talks about where the fear mongering of the Vaseline has got to stop. But however, I will make a distinction that we're looking at the pure Vaseline, not the cocoa butter one or any other variations, the pure one. Now, another option for winter worn skin and some other scenarios that I'm gonna tell you about is the Aquaphor Healing Ointment. So this is similar to Vaseline. It has a couple more ingredients than Vaseline does. I will link it below so you can check it out. I like to use Aquaphor in areas where maybe I had some like friction and I needed to kind of like heal that area. I even like to have a smaller tube of this that I stick in my purse when I travel, because when I travel on a plane, and this is even before COVID, the airplane air would dry out my nose and then cause me to have like a little ear, nose, and throat, a little action, be like when I got off the plane. So what I started to do was I would stick a little of the Aquaphor in my nose. This helps to keep the moisture from coming out and from my nose drying out, thereby lessening the that I would have after a flight. And this is just $4.59. Now, I know y'all love your CeraVe healing ointment, and I tried to get it for this video, but your cousins and them and y'all just keep buying it up and you just can't get it. This is probably the only product that's over 10 bucks in this video. This is the Aveeno Baby Eczema Relief Balm. The version that I used was the adult version. I couldn't get my hands on it, it was sold out, but this and the adult version have identical ingredient lists, so I'm gonna assume it's probably the same product with maybe a few differences, right? However, what I love this for, it's a super, super thick balm. In the beginning of the Pandora's box, when I was washing my hands way too aggressively, way too often, I developed a patch of dryness that turned into some discoloration, because remember, irritation can lead to inflammation, it can lead to hyperpigmentation, and that was all up on my hand. So I would wash my hands and then I would put this on top of it, and after I would say maybe a week or 2 weeks had passed and the problem had solved itself. Now, of course, I have decreased how how I wash my hands like a crazy person, but this is good. Now, at $17.99, although it is more than the price point of most of the items in this video, I still think this is a good deal. This has colloidal oatmeal in it, which is known for its healing properties, and it also has ceramides in it, which help with the skin barrier. Now, you're probably not showing as much skin in this season as you would in the summertime, but there may be certain circumstances where you want to show some skin indoors, and you're looking to glow a little bit. I got you. Now, this $6.99 Vaseline Coco Radiant Body Oil might be right up your alley to give you some glisten and some shine. Now, this is something I would normally use at night, because during the day, things can get a little, you know, it can get a little iffy when you're trying to put your sunscreen on top. However, during the day, there are sunscreen body oils, and I've done some videos where I talked about a few, so make sure you check those out. But something like this, you can glisten and glow all over your body, Audie. Now, in the wintertime, though, I would probably still put my moisturizer on, hop out the shower while I'm still a little damp, apply my cream, let it sit for a little bit, and then I would put this on top and then just be glistening and glowing. All right, my darlings, now it is your turn to do the talking. What products, what budget skincare products under $20 for the body are you loving right now? Because like I say, and I would try to remember to say it because you know sometimes the memory ain't so great. This is a community, so we love to have community feedback. If you've tried any of the products that were mentioned in this video or others, please let us know your experiences, good or bad. All the products that were mentioned will be linked in the description box, as well as other pertinent information, maybe other videos that you need to watch. And speaking of other videos that you need to watch, I'm gonna link two videos that I want you to check out if you have. One is on my most recent shower routine for the winter season. Exfoliation, razor bump, hair removal, and the feminine hygiene and all that other stuff. And another one is a recent shop with me at Sephora. So if you're looking for my bourgeois, check out that video. I shop for some of the best skincare products for the body. Follow me on social and I'll see you in my next video.